Hello, it's been a little while, but I thought I'd make a little day in my life video. Honestly, like, school is just amazing. Like, I can't recommend going to Rose Bruford enough if you're like applying or interested in going to drama schools. Q&A with you while I get ready. A little thing to mention, all my skincare is Wildman and it's so good and I genuinely really recommend. It's a brand that I like often work with. Sorry, my skin is always perfect. And I have Wildman to thank for that. Oh my God, that feels so nice. I love like putting my moisturizer on and then giving myself a little massage while I'm doing that. Also, I was like really shocked at how many questions I received, to be honest. So I'm gonna do a separate Q&A video. I'm gonna answer like literally a few questions now, and then I'm gonna do like a whole Q&A video on drama school and like ask again if you have any questions. I'll just answer some fun ones. So firstly, future aspirations. That's an interesting question because my aspirations have changed quite a lot since doing the screen acting course at Rose Bruford that we've been doing the past 2 weeks. Before, I definitely would have mainly wanted to do stage acting, and like I would have said that if someone asked me before, that would be my like main goal, because I think the feeling that you get from doing stage is a feeling like no other. I do still stand by that. But then now I've discovered how I feel from doing film, and it's just a different feeling, but it's also so rewarding and it ignites so much within me. I'd literally love to do anything now. I think that's actually such a great thing about Bruford, because I'm writing a play and Bruford really encourages creativity, and I never would have decided to write a play having not been at Bruford. It's because we do these symposium shows, which if you know nothing about, is basically a kind of student-led festival of student-made work. It's basically a celebration and a festival for a week straight after the Easter half term of stuff that students have been working on off their own back. So I'm writing, directing and being in my own symposium, which is very exciting. I think that it's a great thing to do because I know now, as soon as I leave Bruford, I have something to fall back on if I need it. This play I'm already loving, I've already started rehearsals for it, and I'm just like really excited by the whole process and how it's going. So I think my future aspirations are genuinely just to create all the time, to be like secure in my career, but also that doesn't just involve acting, you know, like I'm a yoga teacher as well, and I think as long as I feel fulfilled by what I'm doing, that is enough for me. I do just want to have like constant work. If anyone wants any of my makeup details, I mainly use Refi for everything. Refi is the best makeup brand ever. How do you balance being both beautiful and smart? The people want to know. Period. Do you need to have A-level drama to go to drama school? No. They don't care about anything that you've done previously. They just want to see you in the audition. Whatever you bring on the audition day will decide whether you get in or not. Maybe A-level drama will help you, but you don't need to have picked it, no. Just applied tips for the audition process as a whole. Okay, getting into it. Audition tip, one and only tip, to be honest. I think it's everything that Rose Bruford is about and stands for. Make it about the other person. You will find the answers not in yourself, but in the person that you're doing the text to. When you do your speeches, I'm sure that they give you someone to do your speech to. I think it will be a student or a graduate. Make it about them. What do you want from the person? What is your intention? How are you affecting them? What do you see in them? Listen to them, like let it be an active conversation. So you've learnt the lines and you know the lines and you know the character and the backstory and everything like that well enough to just let that go in the moment. And so when you're doing it, you are completely on them. You're completely trying to affect this change in them. So you need to know what you want out of it, but be willing to take whatever opportunity they give you in their eyes. So however they're reacting, That's giving you something. That's feeding your performance. Make it about them. In the third round as well, they give you a duologue to do. Make it about the other person. Everything is about either the ensemble and how you feed into the ensemble, because Ray's Bruford have the best ensemble members. Like, everything we do is so ensemble. Like, you have to be a good ensemble member to get into Bruford. Even in the games, like, everything, the answer is always looking right in front of you, outside yourself. Secondary tip that will help with this is to breathe. Like, do a warm-up, period. Like, do a warm-up, but focus it on breath. Do some, like, deep yogi squats, or semi-supine, or something to get the breath down. Just, like, do anything that will allow you to come back to your breath. Breath is so important, and it will also just, like, calm your nerves. It will allow your lines, your interactions, everything to come easier. Like, breath is everything. I'm in the Rose Bruford Foundation right now. Any tips for second round BA audition? Use your mind in a technique. Only do something if it feels really truthful. You don't have to act, because it's not about acting, it's about listening. That is, like, the main tip I want to give everyone. Listen, just listen. It's about generosity and, like, how much of yourself are you, like, willing to share with the space. Be generous with yourself, be generous with your energy, and be patient with yourself as well, like, in that same vein. Know that whatever's gonna happen is gonna happen. And there's literally, like, no need to force anything or to, like, worry, because it's all working out in your favor, regardless of what the result is, you know? And also, just a general bit of knowledge to tell you, from doing a foundation, a lot of people don't get in the first year while they're doing the foundation. They get in the year after they finish the foundation. If you don't get in while you're doing the foundation, don't worry at all. And I'd just say as well, if you're doing the foundation at Rose Bruford, just connect with the teachers, show up every single day, and prove that you're worth a place, because it will really help you. You have the opportunity, if you're doing the Rose Bruford Foundation, to prove how worth a place you are. So every single day, do actionable things that show how great a student you are and how lucky they'd be to have you. Okay, I'm gonna end the Q&A there, because there's a lot more questions. So I'm just gonna put it in a separate Q&A. I hope that you found that helpful, and then I'll take you through the rest of my day now. Thank you. So we're all going to a funeral for her Bill scene.
Yeah, it's really painful.
Please, no videos.
You're grieving.
No paparazzi.
And I'm gonna log off for tonight because I'm a little bit knackered. I hope you've enjoyed this video. I will be doing a Q&A very shortly because obviously we've got so many questions. But yeah, thank you so much for watching and I'll see you very soon. Bye.